Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Anna and I'm the blogger behind yourartpath.com. If you are new to this channel or my blog, simply welcome. Today I have a new review video of a tablet by XP Pen. This is a new one. It is called Innovator 16. It is the first one in its series, so I'm very, very excited to check it out. I have done a review previously, a couple of months ago, for XP Pen Artist 15.6 Pro, and I will leave a link down in the description somewhere. I love that tablet, and I've been using it for the past couple of months. So now my question to this new tablet, is it worth the upgrade? I know it's a newer model, it's supposed to be slimmer, and supposed to have a little better quality of color. But in order to know if we should upgrade to this newer model, it is always best to just dive right in and start drawing and painting and seeing how it feels. I hope you're as excited as me to get started on this review, and let's dive right in, shall we? Alright guys, now is the moment we've all been waiting for. Let's open this bad boy up and see what's inside. Hey, here's the tablet. That looks amazing. Let's pull it. Oh, all right. So basically what I noticed right away is that it is pretty heavy still. So obviously durable, but it is very slim. Comparing to the previous one that I reviewed, this is so thin. I'm actually going to grab a pen from the previous XP Pen to show you just how slim it is. As you can see, it's probably as thin as this ending of the pen, but then the pen is thicker than the actual tablet. That is crazy. Or if we just take a pencil is about as thick as this. That is insane. All right, so that looks really good, and I will obviously dive into more detail about this tablet, but let's see what else is inside. All right, we have some power adapters as per usual. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we have the pen. Oh, I'm really excited to see the pen. I figured it has a little bit of a different design than the one from Artist 15.6 Pro. So I'm definitely very excited to see this. Yeah, look at that, guys. It's so stylish. It has a slim design. It is beautiful and yet elegant. If we compare it to the old one from the previous review, they're obviously quite different. I'm very used to this one, so it feels very comfortable in my hand at the moment. And I don't know how we will be working with this one and if anything will be different, but it does feel very comfortable at the moment as well. So smooth. So I can't wait to try working with it. And of course, you have your 8 nibs. If you are a rough painter or if you just paint a lot, you will definitely need to change these up with time. And let's see what we have here in this tiny box. Aww, you guys. XP Pen team is the best. They always put in something extra, something to make your day, something to make you happy. I love that. I don't know if I mentioned yet, but it is about to be their 15th anniversary. So congratulations to the XP Pen team, of course. I think 15 years in the business of making tablets and making artists happy and making their lives better is definitely something to be proud of. So congratulations to the team. Here's their Phoenix, the little fox, their mascot. So cute. Thank you so much, XP Pen team. Always trying to make us happier by adding little gifts here and there. That was really cute and unexpected. If you get it as well, sorry for ruining the surprise. Then we have some cables, another glove. Well, not another, a glove to paint with. What is this? That is something exciting. Aw, 15th anniversary, drawing different. I love this.
What is that? Okay. I haven't sent a letter ever. And maybe I should. It seems like a fun thing to do. Just look at that. Little Phoenix in London. He's traveling the world. And we can send these as postcards. Oh, these are so beautiful. They are amazing. I love them. That is so adorable. That is beyond adorable. I love it. Thank you, guys. Just like, so I always love when I buy something and then something extra comes with it. And it doesn't have to be something crazy. It's just like even one postcard. It just makes me feel like the company cares about me as a person. So I really appreciate it. We have our warranty policy and a quick guide for those of you who never had XP Pen before, or you need to refresh your memory so you can set it up properly. There's something else. Aw, look at that. And what else do we have? We have our wiping cloth and, all right, we also have a pen. Drawing different. I love that. I love that saying. Very heavy. Oh, okay. Yeah, it is a pen. Also for their 15th anniversary. Oh my god, congratulations. I should like add some visual effects here of maybe some fireworks or something, because I'm actually so happy for them. 15 years is awesome. I'm so happy. I love everything that's in here. Obviously, I'm the most excited about the little gifts and the tablet, of course. So now I'm just going to go ahead and set it up. Set up the tablet, set up the hotkeys, just figure out what it looks like, how everything works, and then I will start and try to actually use it and let you know how that goes. Before that, here is what my XP Pen setup looks like at the moment. Alright guys, I just want to very quickly show you my current setup. I have the XP Pen right here, and it is connected by a bunch of cables to a bunch of places, and my laptop, which is right here, so I can still use hotkeys to go ahead and keep working on Photoshop. It has these Phoenix in here. You can watch the whole review, and I will leave a link down in the description. Also, I just wanted to show you that basically I have some Van Gogh books and other books, and this is the stand. So I have the stand on the box because otherwise I am not comfortable. But if you just put a bunch of books behind it, you'll be fine. Alright, now let's get back to the Innovator 16, and I'm going to set it up in the exact same place as this one is, because that's kind of my workspace, and we'll just get started drawing. So now that we've unboxed the XP Pen, I'm going to connect it, I'm going to set up the hotkeys, and then I will start painting and drawing to check out what it feels like to actually work with the tablet, because it is the most important part of the tablet. It's not what it looks like or how many hotkeys it has, it's about the actual experience. So let's see what that experience will be like for me while I'm working with it, and I will share with you all the details. Let's dive right in. So I've just set up everything and connected the tablet to my laptop. It was a pretty easy thing to do. You just download the driver from their website that you can find in the link down in the description. You can find the driver there. Then you install the driver. Make sure to uninstall. If you've previously had an XP Pen tablet, you make sure to uninstall that old driver and install the new one, and then set up all the hotkeys, and that's it. So pretty much right now I'm setting up the hotkeys and I'll be ready to start working. But before we do that, I wanted to quickly show you the comparison between Artist 15.6 Pro and Innovator Display 16. So if you look at their displays alone, they are identical 15.6 inches displays. But the thickness is 11 millimeters with Artist 15.6 Pro and 9 millimeters with Innovator Display 16. It is only 9 millimeters. I'm not even kidding. It is so slim. It's just crazy. That's why it is probably perfect to travel around with. I don't know. I haven't tried it yet, but it does feel like something that you could just put in your bag and go to work or go to school and just take it with you wherever you want to go.
So if we look at the actual display, we have a full laminated technology. It seamlessly combines the glass and the screen, so it is the same identical for both of them. Looking at the styluses, both of them are battery free with 60 degree tilt, meaning you can shade if some brushes allow for that, and you have up to 8,192 levels of pressure sensitivity, which pretty much means you can vary the thickness from thin to thick and vary the opacity and just feel like you're working with some traditional tools. This is probably the most important thing about a stylus, is the level of pressure sensitivity, and I feel like this is good enough and it works great. They both come with portable stands. You should use a book underneath if it is too low for you, because I know some people prefer working as if they're working on a table, and other people love working as if they're working on an easel. So this one's kind of in between. So if you like to work more on a table, then just don't use the stand. And if you like easels more, just put some stuff underneath it to make it stand up taller. They both connect via 3-in-1 cable, which is pretty cool because you don't need to have three separate cables, they are connected. And then you can connect it to your laptop or computer alone or use a power adapter. When it comes to color, the Artist 15.6 Pro has 120% sRGB, while its Innovator Display has 125% sRGB, which is 5% better colors. And it might not be very noticeable to the naked eye, but as I've been working with the tablet on the left for 8 months and moving to Innovator Display, I did notice an increase in saturation. Also, the Artist 15.6 Pro has 8 shortcut keys and 1 roller wheel, which I love. It's like my favorite thing ever. And then Innovator Display comes with the same 8 shortcut keys, 1 roller wheel, but it also has 1 virtual wheel inside of it, which is really interesting. You can also set it up to be whatever a roller wheel can be. I found it to be very, very useful. It took me some time to get used to it, but it was so cool. And finally, if we look at the prices, the Artist Display 15.6 Pro costs $449.99 US, and Innovator Display 16 is $499.99. So basically $50 difference, and you get 5% better colors, you get an extra roller wheel, and a super slim tablet. And now let's go ahead and talk about the experience of drawing, because I actually went ahead and completed a drawing on the next day. And I was following the same idea as the main art for the Innovator Display 16, with this pink-haired, beautiful girl with coral reefs and in her hair and some fish. And she's just so gorgeous and peaceful. I absolutely love the idea, so I decided to follow along with that kind of atmosphere and also create a drawing of my own while I'm trying to learn how to work with this new tablet. So I set up the keys to be similar to what I had in the previous one. The only major difference is that in the previous one, I didn't have the extra roller wheel. So in this case, the big roller wheel represents changing the brush size, and the smaller one zooms in or out, which is really cool. And so I was just drawing, and it was about 1 a.m. when I started, and I just thought maybe I'll create a simple sketch and just call it a day, you know, just experiment a little bit and feel it out and see if I like it more. But then I just kind of couldn't stop. I think that happens to you sometimes too. You just start a drawing and then you just can't stop, right? If that does happen to you, let me know in the comments so that I'm not alone, a crazy human working till like 4 a.m. in the morning. I just want to take a quick short break to remind you to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell button if you're enjoying this content. It means the world to me. Also, let me know in the comments if you think that it is worth the upgrade from the previous model or from any other model that you're working with. I am curious to know what models are you guys using, so maybe I can get one for myself as well. And now, let's go back to the content.
So I was just doing the sketch, and somehow the tablet felt a little bit bigger to me, in a sense of like I felt that the display is bigger, that I have more space to work with. While it's not true, because the other tablet has the same display, it just felt bigger, I think, because of how slim it is. So it kind of extends it visually, and I thought that was really pleasant. It was just pleasant to work with this because it looks so
stylish, I'd say, and it does match my laptop. My laptop is this like gray and black, and it's gray and black, and so it just looks beautiful together. I really enjoyed working with this tablet. I felt that the stylus was sitting more and more comfortably in my hand as I worked. Of course, at first it's a little bit weird, just like any stylus or any tablet or any tool that you start using. At first it is a little bit weird or awkward because it's the first time that you're working with it, but the more I spent drawing and sketching and painting, the less I was feeling the stylus. It happens to me that if I'm very comfortable, I just don't even think about what tool I'm using. It just sort of happens. And I guess that's kind of what was happening with this stylus. I wasn't even thinking about what this stylus does or how it feels because it was just so comfortable in my hand. And I put the same shortcut keys on the stylus as I used in my old tablet, so it just felt like home. It felt like something I've been using forever. So other than a little more saturated colors and the extra wheel, which was actually very time-saving, that's cool, and the stylish look, I didn't notice any much more difference, but I guess they are very similar tablets. This one's just, you know, newer, looks better, has one extra wheel, and a little better colors. Whether it's worth the $50 extra? You know what? Probably. Just because it's more pleasant to look at. But if in your eyes the previous tablet looks better and you think you don't need the extra wheel, then for sure the other tablet is amazing. I've been using it for 8 months and I love it. Now, will I keep using this one or go back to the old one? I have to be honest with you. I think I will keep using this one just because I love how it looks. And if your workspace looks amazing, you're just more likely to feel inspired and go work. As for me, I will be making the switch to this tablet for now because I think I do like the look of it more, and the extra wheel, although it was a little bit weird to use at the beginning, has become a big time saver for me personally, as I do love shortcut keys. They're my favorite. I do want a bigger size display in a very near future, but for now, this is the one I'll be using. So if you think that this display size is good for you, I think it's a really good tablet. I definitely got lost in time and I was just enjoying playing around, having fun, while if you see the corner of my iPad at the top of this video, that was me watching Netflix while I was drawing, and you know, it's just having fun. I love art because it allows me to have fun all the time, which is what I was doing while I was creating this work. Of course, it didn't turn out perfectly, but I don't know. I feel like artwork is never perfect. It's just as good as it could be on that day. And then I noticed it was 4:22 in the morning, so I decided to go to sleep. The next day, I finished it, added some fishes and some bubbles, and I was ready to call it a day. And the artwork was done. By the way, you can watch the entire time lapse on my Patreon, plus some tips that I'm sharing with this artwork and many others on my Patreon. I also have 4 mini courses on there: Photoshop, sketching, shading, and perspective. So if you're ready to learn some more, check out learn.yourartpath.com or my Patreon. I'll leave links down in the description. So is this tablet a yay or nay? For me, it's a yay. But let me know what you think in the comments down below.
Thank you so much for watching this video, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this content. Do subscribe if you would like to see more of my face and my drawings. I would love to have you as part of our Your Art Path family. Till next time.